Hey guys, okay, today I'm back with a new video. It's been a while since I've made a video because ever since the movement control order has been lifted, I've been busy with work. So finally I got, last week I made an order for a watch that I really wanted. So it has arrived in the mail. And I'm going to talk a little bit about my experience purchasing this particular watch from a company called the Switch Watch Expo. They're a watch dealer in the United States, in Georgia specifically. So, it has always been a little bit of a challenge to buy watches overseas from a foreign country back to Malaysia. Mainly because of, there are a lot of considerations. You are worried that whether they will sell you a fake watch, whether or not the package will get lost in transit and stuff like that. But as we can see, the watch is here, so the deal went well. So I placed the order last week on Tuesday and the watch arrived today, which is Tuesday. It is 6 days in total. It took 6 days from the time I place order, make payment, and for that the shipping is very quick. Once I've completed my payment, the next morning they shipped the package out straight away, and it was shipped by UPS. And since it was the first time buying from Switch Watch Expo, I was a bit worried, but of course I did my research. They have quite good reviews on the internet, not much complaints. So I actually even used Google Earth to check if they actually have a store. So all in all, I was quite confident with them, so that's why I went ahead. And when the package arrived at the Malaysian customs, I actually got a broker to help me do the custom clearance. And when they sent me the picture of the package, at first I was a bit worried. If you look at it, the box seems quite flat. So I was wondering, could this Rolex packaging be so flat? Did they not send me the original box, or did they send me a wrong package? I was a bit worried. But when I received it, I opened it up. As you can see in the video, everything checks out, everything's fine. But I think Switch Watch Expo could improve a little bit on their packaging, maybe include some bubble wrap, or put in some of those styrofoam peanuts just to protect the box a little bit. We're lucky enough, the box seems fine, there was no damage to it, but there really isn't much protection. So I think thumbs up to UPS for handling the package well. So without further ado, let's go in and have a look at this watch. So I think, as I've mentioned in one of my previous, or in fact a few of my previous videos, I'm a guy who likes to wear gold. But at the same time, I don't want something to be too in your face kind of gold. So when I saw this particular model, the Yachtmaster 126621, the two-tone Yachtmaster in Everose Gold, I fell in love with it. It is so beautiful. But the thing with Yachtmasters are, they are not very photogenic. In pictures they might look, okay, but in person, when you look at the real thing, it is really beautiful. Okay, so this is a brand new piece, unworn, right? So immediately you can see this watch glittering and shining, catching the light in different angles. It's really a beautiful watch. I actually already have the platinum bezel with the blue dial, and I loved it so much. And when I saw this two-tone one, I really fell in love, and ever since I've been searching for hunting for a piece with the right price. So So I would say I got this at a very good price. I will not disclose the price on the on this video, but it was a very good price, hence I bought it all the way from US. Yep. So this is the 126621. If you can see, there's the little crown in between the Swiss made, which means this has the newer 3235 movement. Okay. So before I decided to buy this model, I was actually considering between this and the RootBeer, the 126711 CHNR, the RootBeer. That is also a two-tone. I really love the color. I love the bezel color. I love how it really blends well with the Everose Gold. After looking at this, I had was wondering which one to get, but as we all know, the RootBeer in the recent months, the price has skyrocketed like crazy. It is now going for, you know, anywhere between 125 to 135,000 Malaysian ringgit. Even this particular model, it's actually going for somewhere between 95 to 105,000 ringgit. So I didn't manage to find a piece of the RootBeer that has the right price, but yet I found this, so I guess it's fate. So in the end I got this. But after getting this, I don't know, maybe I'm biased, but after getting this, I actually think I like this more than the RootBeer. This one is a little bit more classy, a little bit dressier, a little bit more elegant, you know, because the case profile is less bulky and there are a lot of polished surfaces around, whereas the RootBeer, they are a little bit more brushed, a little bit squarer, not so tapered. So yes, the RootBeer will look a little bit more tooly, and this will look a little bit more dressier. So I think this would go well with semi-formal attire, or even formal attire when you attend dinners or events, formal events. It's not so much a casual watch. I couldn't see myself wearing this with, you know, maybe jeans and t-shirt. It's a bit more of a dressier watch. So after deciding to get this model, comes the next question. Should I get the one with the black dial like you see here, or the other version, the M126621-0001? That one has a chocolate dial with a sunburst effect. In picture, definitely, no questions asked, the chocolate dial looks much better. It looks more interesting, you know, it catches the light, there's the sunburst effect. But if you look at it in the real person, I mean, if you look at the real thing, I actually personally think this black one looks way better because of the contrast. Because if you see, there is this Everose Gold hands, and even the rims are all in Everose Gold. So if you have the chocolate dial, you lack that sort of contrast. The whole watch just looks monotonous. It doesn't really stand out, you see, because the gold on the chocolate dial is really, it really lacks that. I don't know how to put it into words, but for me, I think this is the best looking one, the black one, and it makes it super legible. It's so easy to read. See, I mean, this watch itself is already blingy enough. I can make do without the chocolate dial, without the sunburst effect. So yeah, I think this black dial balances out the whole look of the watch. Okay, so maybe just a quick look around at this watch. As I mentioned, this is brand new. I have not sized it yet, still in full links. Unfortunately, this piece doesn't come with an upright crown it doesn't come with an upright crown. I have a little bit of an OCD with this. I know I have my previous blue Yachtmaster. When you tighten the crown, it's exactly upright like this. Well, doesn't matter. Doesn't affect the watch in any way, it's just me. So yeah, Rolex being a Rolex, the bezel movement is really crisp. it's very quiet. It's unlike the Submariner, but it doesn't mean that it's mushy and unprecise. It's really very precise, click by click. You can feel it, but you can't really hear it. Okay, it's bi-directional, so you can rotate it anyway. Right? Very, very nice watch. You really have to see this watch in person to really appreciate it. In pictures, it really doesn't stand up. Okay? In fact, what I'm looking through the camera and what I'm looking at the real thing, I mean, it just looks different. The real thing really looks amazing. Let me maybe do a little wrist shot. Well, I'll just put it on. I'm a left-handed, so I wear my watches on my right wrist. So I have a 17 centimeter wrist. It sits perfectly. Very beautiful and very comfortable, I would say. See, the thing with watches that comes with precious metal, well, in case those of you who don't know, this whole bezel, including the middle links of the bracelet, is made from what Rolex call the Everose gold. Basically, it's platinum mixed with gold mixed with copper to achieve this color. So it is not plated. It is a solid piece, so you can polish it. Even if you polish it until it's halfway down, you lose all the markings, but the color will still remain the same. This is the good thing about Rolex's Everose gold. Unlike some other watchmakers, they just plate it. So if you polish it, you tend to lose the color, but you that doesn't happen here. Okay? The thing with watches that has precious metal, as I was mentioning earlier, the moment you pick it up, the weight, the heft it has, I really like it. It feels really solid. It's slightly heavier than the other sport models like the Submariner or the GMTs. This one really feels solid and heavy. Okay. I guess this might be personal preference. Some people might like a lighter watch, but somehow holding this piece in the hand really feels high quality watch. Okay. It's really, I mean, you can feel the weight to it. I have the 114060 Submariner. It's a beautiful watch, but when you pick it up, it doesn't feel as heavy as this watch. So this is another plus point for me. Okay. So one question I really get a lot from my friends is that, hey, you always buy these watches from overseas seller. You haven't seen the actual watch. How do you know if they didn't sell you a fake? I mean, over the years of collecting Rolexes and other watches, you just know what to look for. I have compared it with a lot of a lot of really good replicas. No matter how good the replicas are, there are certain things that can immediately tell you whether or not it's genuine. Okay, the first thing would be the One of the tips I could give you is definitely the Cyclops, alright, the 2.5 times magnification. On the genuine, it's really clear and it's really, how should I say, it's, I don't know how to put it into words, but if you have a chance, get a replica, compare it side by side and you will understand. The Cyclops is the biggest tell. No matter how expensive, no matter how much you pay for the replica, a replica is still a replica and they could not replicate this Cyclops. Of course, there are also pieces in the market where they actually put on original parts onto the replica. They could have just slapped on a genuine crystal on it and it might look legit, but of course there are other telltales as well. I mean, the engraving on the rehaut, the heft to it, everything, even the warranty card. Okay, I won't go in depth on how I actually make sure that this piece is genuine, but I have my way of identifying these watches. Okay, even the winding of the mechanism, the feel of it, immediately you can tell. All right, even the replicas, they might copy the movement, the 3235 movement exactly, the design, you open the case back, it will look the same, but the moment you wind it, that's it, you will know. All right, so I'm very happy with this purchase. I'm also overall satisfied with the services from SwitchWatch Expo. You can visit their website and have a look. Well, if there is any feedback, I would say they could improve a little bit on their communication. I mean, don't get me wrong, communication was great. When I placed the order, I sent them an email, they promptly reply me. But the issue here is that they only reply what they want to reply. Okay, I emailed them, I placed an order, they sent me an email with the payment instructions. I replied that saying that I had to split my payment into two because my online transfer limit for foreign accounts is capped at a certain amount. So I had to make my payment twice. So in between the email correspondence, I did ask them if it comes with the complete set, the hang tags. I also asked if they could provide me some pictures, and I also requested that they send me a soft copy receipt or an invoice, which I would then use for custom clearance, but they totally ignored that part of the email. They did not reply to that. But they replied to me and acknowledged that they received my payment and they proceed to send the watch out. No issue with that. I mean, there wasn't any issue, so yeah, not much to complain, but I would really appreciate if they could actually reply to my questions or answer my questions. As you see, just now I took the card out. It's just the card. Where is the leather pouch that holds the card? I actually asked in the email if it comes with it because I didn't see the picture of it on their website, but they didn't reply, so I guess I just have to live without that card holder. I mean, no biggie, it's just a card holder, you can buy it online, a couple of bucks, but yeah, these are little complaints. Other than that, very satisfied, very happy with the service. They actually threw in a little nice little watch carrier, watch box, or what you may call it. Okay, it can carry one watch. Comes with a microfiber cloth to clean your watches. Okay, they also gave a nice little thank you card. Okay, and they did include the receipt, which I will not show here. It's inside, but yeah. Comes with the certification tag. Other than that, nothing much. As with all Rolex boxes, nothing interesting to see here. I really love how Omega does their boxes, but that you can see that in my other videos. So last but not least, beautiful watch. Trust me, look at this in the flesh. Look at the real thing. You will love it.